At 4:54 p.m. local time on July 10, 2025, an unexpected explosion, albeit a natural one, occurred in El Salvador. As scalding hot water and chunks of mud were thrown more than 150 feet into the air, nearby people panicked, running away from falling debris and then an advancing steam plume. This steam plume might have looked fairly harmless, but there is a good chance anyone caught in it for more than a split second would have received some form of burn. What had just happened, despite occurring on the flanks of a potentially active volcano known as the Apaneca Range, was strangely enough not a volcanic eruption. Instead, it represented an instance of the same phenomenon which closed off a portion of Yellowstone's Biscuit Basin after a similar series of explosions in 2024 and 2025. What I am referring to is known as a hydrothermal explosion. In its aftermath, the extent of the explosion became clear. More than a dozen trees had been outright killed, demolished, or damaged, an area of what I have geolocated to be 5,396 square meters, or 1.33 acres, was covered in a layer of mud, and material had been ejected as far as 67 meters, or 220 feet away. While some reports seemingly claim that a brand new crater measuring a whopping 70 meters wide and 20 meters deep was created by this explosion, I have been completely unable to verify the formation of such an unexpectedly large new feature. However, what I can confirm is the formation of at least a new 23 meter wide crater that I hypothesized was the explosion's epicenter, which completely destroyed a 40 foot long tiny little peninsula that existed in this known hot spring feature. If you are wondering how this explosion compares to the Black Diamond Pool's explosion on July 23rd of 2024, the answer is that it was actually 59% smaller. Regardless, in both instances, several people were quite close to being harmed or worse, but thankfully neither instance led to any injuries. And this is not the first time a hydrothermal explosion has occurred at this hot spring, which is known as Agua Chuca. At least one hydrothermal explosion occurred in the years of 1868, 1990, and 2005. The 1990 explosion was far larger than what was witnessed this month, resulting in 26 fatalities and ejecting mud as far as 200 meters distant. Since I have been unable to geolocate the exact extent the 1990 hydrothermal explosion impacted, I have simply shaded in a perfect circle for comparison. It is unknown if more hydrothermal explosions will follow at this same location, but in my opinion, it is possible. But why exactly did this hydrothermal explosion occur in the first place? Per a direct quote from the U.S. Geological Survey, hydrothermal explosions occur when shallow interconnected reservoirs of fluids with temperatures at or near the boiling point underlie thermal fields. These fluids can rapidly transition to steam if their pressure suddenly drops. Since vapor molecules take up much more space than liquid molecules, the transition to steam results in significant expansion and blows apart surrounding rocks and ejects debris. While in the case of Yellowstone's Black Diamond Pool, this involved a copper plug of silica sinter, in El Salvador, I believe the culprit involved another finely green substance, clay. The fault line which transports hot water upwards and feeds Agua Chuca also pulverizes rock and sediment into finely grained particles small enough to become clay, specifically less than 1/256th of a millimeter in diameter. This might create a spectacle similar in appearance to a phreatic eruption, but phreatic eruptions involve direct heating by magma, while hydrothermal explosions do not involve heating by magma, often just the geothermal temperature gradient, and can even occur in some areas with no young volcanoes. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Nakarts, for supporting my work.